everyone. So in this section I will just discuss about how do we identify the object. So to do that, we import an image using imread command. So the left hand variable would be img1, then imshow is the command to display those images. Once we load the image into the imread command, the image file 01 jpeg has been loaded to img1, and we display that image using imshow command. Then further we proceed with taking the predictions. So for making predictions, we use AlexNet, which is a CNN architecture, and we load that to the DeepNet. Now we perform classification using DeepNet architecture for IMG1 and make the prediction. Finally, task 3 would be classifying for the further images. That is, when I say I have a CNN architecture, any CNN architecture can be loaded to deep neural network as DeepNet, and this right now we are loading AlexNet. So the neural network is DeepNet, input data is IMG1. We are giving these two as the input to the classifier for classify. I hope you would have used this classify command in machine learning on run course, and the output has been given to predict1. So you would see the output on the command window. Finally, in the task 3, similar manner we can imply for further images for predict2 and predict3 for IMG2 and IMG1. So any image, we can follow the same procedure, do the classification, and you can load with any neural network or convolutional neural network. Right now here we are using just AlexNet network. Next task would be studying the CNN architecture. To study the CNN architecture, firstly we need to load all the layers. So to load all the layers, we use deepnet.layers. This loads all 25 layers of the AlexNet. Now if you want to extract each and every layer and study how they are, you can say ly of 1, that is the first layer. So you can call it with a variable in layer, and this gives the first layer. If you want to see the input size of that, we go with in layer dot input size to a variable inz. So it gives you what is the input size of this first layer. If we want to extract the last layer, we give ly of n, which will be loaded to the output layer, and the output of the last layer would be the category names or the class names of the classifier. So we can give it as category names outlayer dot classes, which gives us what are the category names. Maybe it is flowers, seashore, or whatever category names we consider. If it is flower, we can say rose, lily, whatever. If it is vehicles, we would have named it as car, bike, or anything like that. So that would be the category names. So this architecture helps us study how the classification process is happening stage by stage. That is, loading the image, extracting features, performing the task of or the convolutions, and finally from the output layer, from numbers to conversion of categories and seeing the output. Once the CNN architecture has been understood, we proceed with investigating the predictions. But investigating predictions is very easy because you have already completed MATLAB on-ramp course. And so now we classify the data set, and the remaining tasks are very simple. Just creating bar graph of the prediction score, set a threshold for that scores, use logical indexing and modify the bar graph, label the bar chart. So all these tasks are very simple, as we have already implemented with MATLAB on RAM and we have already completed with the machine learning on RAM. These particular tasks should remain easy to complete for investigating the predictions. Not necessarily we go with bar graph, we can implement pie chart or line graph or any graph to analyze how the prediction scores are varying. Thank you.